Have you ever seen how insects fly erratically around some light sources, such as lamps in your house or the streetlight poles? Do you know why insects do that? Almost all of us are familiar with this. The way insects behave around light sources is something scientists didn't know how to explain until recently. But now it seems like we finally have an answer to this, and it's incredibly depressing. Are you ready to find out? Let's get started. For a long time, biologists who observed insects believed that this behavior was due to insects using sunlight to orient themselves in dark areas. Scientists believe insects confused the light from the spotlights with the sunlight seen from the tree's foliage, so they flew towards the light, thinking it was the sun. However, insects had never been seen to fly toward the sun. Because of this, scientists believe that perhaps insects were attracted to heat. After all, most lamps and light bulbs emit heat similar to, but more focused than, the sun. However, the explanation fell apart when experiments were done using LED lamps, which emit almost no heat. Yet the insects continued flying towards these light sources. This means that insects were not attracted to the sun. Another, perhaps more convincing explanation was that the insects confused the light of our lamps with the light of the full moon. At night, the brightest illumination source is the moon, although we know that it does not emit its light but reflects that of the sun. Scientists believe insects use the moon's light to orient themselves at night. Biologists suspected that perhaps some insects have migration cycles that adjust to the phases of the moon, and that is why the lights from our spotlights and lamps disorient them, causing them to travel toward our sources of light instead of traveling in the direction of the moon itself. However, when scientists analyzed the behavior of insects in environments where only moonlight was present, they never observed that they had any unique or different behavior than when the moon was not present. An insect had also never been observed trying to fly toward the moon, so it was clear that insects were not attracted to moonlight and weren't even mistaking our lights for the moon. So, what was happening? Why are insects attracted to our lights? To answer this question of why insects fly towards light sources once and for all, scientists used a straightforward method. They placed different lamps with different types of lighting and in different positions. They observed them with special cameras that captured many images per second, allowing them to capture the flight of the insects in slow motion. They discovered something exciting by carefully observing each of the insects' wing movements. Everything seems to indicate that the insects don't fly toward the light sources. On the contrary, most insects always fly in the opposite direction to the light source, pointing their back toward the light as if they were trying to escape from them. Another thing that they were able to observe is that the insects that were far from the light source usually flew normally until they suddenly approached the light source and stayed there flying in circles until something took them out of there. All right, what does this all mean? To understand it, we must go back a little into the past, to the origin of insects. But before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos. Insects have existed on Earth for millions of years, appearing approximately 480 million years ago in the Ordovician period, along with the first land plants. Although the first insects in history did not have wings, as time went by, winged insects began to become more and more abundant and prospered much faster than insects that did not have them. So winged insects quickly began to have a larger population. Initially, the insects were giant. An insect from 480 million years ago would be as giant as a cat. But as the planet's temperature began to change, the size of insects also began to decrease. With each new generation of insects, they adapted and improved, reducing their size and surviving the mass extinctions that devastated many species throughout history. For hundreds of millions of years, insects were present in all ecosystems on the planet and developed different senses that helped them thrive and better adapt to the world in which they lived. One of these senses is the response to dorsal light. This sense consists of an ability that insects have to detect light through special biological sensors that they have on their back. This sense benefits them since insects do not see and hear like humans. Insects listen at very low frequencies, and their eyes also observe only at short wave frequencies, which helps them determine the position of the sun at all times. We must also remember that insects are tiny, so a slight temperature change can mean life or death. This is why insects develop a sense of response to dorsal light. This allows them to orient their bodies against the light of the sun, meaning that when an insect is exposed to sun, it will turn its back to the sun instinctively. When the back is pointed towards the sun, the lower part of the insect's body points downwards, right where the vegetation, forests, water, and food it needs to live can be located. This sense allowed the insects to quickly find food sources and orient themselves better during the day. Likewise, in some pollinating insects, this is a way to control their flight altitude by knowing what the horizon is to have a more controlled flight. By feeling the light on their back, they can correct their flight based on the time of day by detecting the brightest light source, which for them is always the sun and the moon. In general, this instinctive behavior helps insects know what is up and what is down. This sense evolved over millions of years, always taking as a reference the brightest light source, the sun. That is, insects evolved to turn their back to the sun. Something similar happened to humans. The sun is so bright for our eyes that we evolved to never look at the sun directly. The response to dorsal light gave insects many benefits that helped them orient themselves, but all this changed when, one day, an intelligent race of monkeys appeared that could create light. That's us, humans. Initially, humans created light with the fire of campfires that our ancestors used to keep warm at night and cook food. For millions of years, insects lived in a world where the only source of light and heat was the sun. But this changed when humans appeared. This new species could create tiny miniature suns and contain them in a small space within crystals. At first, our light sources were candles, but we quickly invented the light bulb and, later, LED lights. All those new light sources changed the night, and everything happened so quickly that the insects didn't have time to adapt. When scientists observed the behavior of insects, they realized that insects do not confuse light bulbs and lamps with the sun. The sense of response to dorsal light makes them react as if these light sources were the sun. That is, insects fly in circles around lamps involuntarily. They only respond instinctively to the light sources, pointing their backs in the opposite direction to the light, since that is how they orient themselves during the day with the sun. When scientists looked at the slow motion recordings of the insects, they realized that the insects' behavior was completely involuntary. When an insect passes near a light source, it does not begin to fly pointing towards the light source, but rather the response to the dorsal light is activated and forces it to reorient its back towards the light source, just as it does with the sun. As a result, the insect appears to be flying around the light source, but in reality, it's not trying to do anything at all. Its body is simply trying to assess where up and down is, with its back turned to the light source. The insects do this instinctively for hours until something like a breeze of wind blows them away from the light source, or they hit their heads directly against it and the impact makes them fall to the ground. In other words, when an insect flies near a light source, it becomes disoriented. In their tiny brains, they are only trying to fly in a straight line, but their instinct tells them that they should point their back toward the light source, since that is where up is. They have no idea they are flying in circles. They are simply disoriented and following their own instincts, thinking they're flying in a straight line. So what happens is that light sources such as lamps or light bulbs interfere with the insect's orientation instincts, especially the response to the dorsal light. The study results indicate that insects respond directly to light sources depending on their orientation. Light sources that point towards them seem to be the least harmful since they point in the same direction as the sun. Still, the worst case scenario is when the light is pointing up, since insects cannot detect where it is up or down and can stay flying, going around in circles, at the light source for hours. This means that the behavior we thought was conscious because insects were attracted to light is, in fact, an utterly involuntary behavior that insects cannot avoid. Now we know that when a moth or fly stays circling a lamp, it is not because it is attracted to the light. It is because it was flying calmly, and when it detected the light, it got trapped there, and now it can no longer escape. Well, now that you know this, will you see this in the same way again? Let us know what you think in the comments.